You know, a number of people also wondering what happens to budget allocations and what they are meant for. Well, those are some of the issues we'll be focusing on this time. Let's go to Abuja for that. Mark, where?
Well, thank you, Chamberlain. We have with us Mr. Daniel Obwala, who is a legal practitioner and also a member of Lincoln's Inn in London. You're welcome to Sunrise Daily.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
No, you did hear the First Lady's words. You know, some people have interpreted that as an attack on the federal government when she said that she visited the ASO Rock Clinic and they were building, but no syringes, the basics to look after patients was not there. What was your assessment of her statement?
Well, thank you for having me. It is intriguing, actually. I hold the view that if a place is called a hospital, and you don't have the basics like syringe, what is it called, the hand gloves and all of that, you don't have a hospital, it's a scam then. That's what it means. And going by what we read, that the budget for the clinic was, I think, $3 billion. $3 billion, in my opinion, can build a world-class hospital, depending on the size. And so if $3 billion is budgeted for how ASO Rock Hospital, but you can't see the basics, then what it goes to show is that this corruption thing that we've been talking about is not just fighting, but corruption resides even in the powerhouse. And this is very, very unfortunate.
It's very worrisome.
And it was reported, I think, about close to a week now when the daughter of the president first raised the concern. And up until this moment, there is no official statement from the government about this fact, whether debunking the fact that the statement is not true or that there is an investigation going on in respect of that. This is one of the many concerns I believe that Nigerians have. And I believe at this point, the president will have to wield the stick. Something is going wrong. Whether you look at it from the perspective of some of his appointees, look at the crisis among the cabinet members, you look at corruption in high places, something has got to happen. Otherwise, that popularity that the anti-corruption fight has will go down. And I'm afraid that it's already going down because people are beginning to feel that maybe the presidency or the president is aware of this kind of development, but is incapable of addressing it. In other climes, things like that will be addressed before the next 24 hours. Somebody has got to answer for that. Somebody will either be suspended until the investigation is done, or the media will be told that this information is incorrect and this are the facts. Just like the case of the NNPC boss and Kachuku, when the first letter was written to the president, the whole nation had the perspective of Kachuku and everybody took his side until we got the information from group managing director of NNPC or from NNPC, Nigerians are able to have a balanced view. So for 1 week that the letter lingered, it created uncertainty. But as soon as a rejoinder or response was made, people tend to have some, you know, kind of clarity. Government must be prompt. Government must respond to needs as and when due. You don't delay a matter because sometimes you may address it, but then it will have been late.
Oh, well, we'll come to that, you know, Kachiku Obaru, maybe even if it's just for 5 minutes in a moment. But then for the First Lady's comments, this is not the first time that she's made, you know, comments that have been regarded as scathing or as an attack on the federal government, which her husband heads and runs.
Right.
You know, there are questions as to, thankfully, the Minister for Health was at that same forum where she made the statement. And, you know, there'll be questions as to what precisely is going on. Do you think that there is a disconnect in the first place? Should the First Lady have said that at that event, or should she have privately asked for an investigation to be carried out into what is going
right
on there?
I hold the view that for the purposes of order, and because of the fact that there is already a discontent and problem around the polity and around the administration of the president, one would expect that in her capacity as a First Lady with privileged position and privileged access, there wouldn't have been need to raise it. From when she visited the hospital and discovered that to when she will address it, probably the address will be that this is what I discovered, I had to do this and this, and then we're able to solve the problem. But to raise that concern as though at the moment was not solved is not just an indictment to the administration. It's an indictment to the Minister of Health. It's an indictment to the Chief of Staff, who is the highest ranking staffer in ASO Villa. It's an indictment to the PAMSEC in the Villa. So in essence, it is an indictment on the government. But let me state at this point that different people do things differently. And what you say or do as a public officer, and especially from that privileged position, send a signal. And so I would have expected, that is my wish, that is my my thought, that the wife of the president or any member of the first family ought not to go public about issues like that. When it is discovered, address it. Then you can now tell the public, this is what has been discovered, and it is addressed. Because the idea is that if the wife of the president could see something like that and had to cry out without a solution, then what it means is that the entire nation is doomed. That's the signal it is sending.